Hey guys, it's Lauren with One Haven Maven, and today's video is all about homeschooling. This year will be our second year homeschooling. My daughter is going into seventh grade, and I thought it might be really helpful if I shared with you which curriculums we're using for each subject and why. So let's get straight into it. Welcome, I'm so glad that you're here. If you are new, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below to see more videos just like this. And if you are a first-time homeschooler, I have a couple of other homeschool videos that might be really helpful for you, and I will link them in the description box below. But otherwise, I post all things home and family content, so if that's you, then subscribe to my channel and keep watching, and let's get right into this one. All right, let's start with science. Last year we used The Good and the Beautiful, and I decided to go with that same curriculum again because I really liked how it made it super simple and very hands-on. One thing you'll notice in most of these curriculums is that there is a lot of hands-on elements. My daughter is a creative type, and she doesn't really like to sit and just like read things or have like lecture type lessons, and so it makes it a little bit trickier, but I have to find things that relate to her and connect with her, and so hands-on is the way to go. Here is the first unit that we're going to study, and it's the botany unit. So it's all about plants and trees. I love the way that The Good and Beautiful is set up. They make it super, super simple, and you know ahead of time exactly what you need. So let me show you. I love that in the very front, it gives you information about the particular unit that you're studying, and it tells you exactly all the things that you're going to need and different components of the unit. And so in this one in particular, you will see that you're going to need a microscope and a science journal, and you're going to have a science wall, and there's going to be experiments. They also give you ideas for field trips and other things that you can do to go along with the unit, which I really like. The next thing that I really like about The Good and the Beautiful science units is that it also tells you for each lesson, like exactly all the supplies that you're gonna need. So you don't have to rush to the store like the day of trying to grab everything or be hunting around your house. So usually what I do is I look at the things on the list and I check to see what I have around my house or shop my house first. And then I usually hit Dollar Tree and I can find most, if not all, of the things that they ask for. My daughter's going into seventh grade this year, as I mentioned, so one of the things I really like about The Good and the Beautiful is they provide the basic lesson that can really go for any age student, but then they have an extension in each of their units, and it works for seventh and eighth grade students. So here's one of the extensions for the science unit, the botany unit. It's all about George Washington Carver, and it gives you instructions at the top so you know exactly what to do, and it tells you in your science journal, write 1 to 2 sentences about each of the following prompts, and it asks various questions, and you get the information from the text and you answer that. And there are other extensions in here, I'm pretty sure for each lesson there is an additional extension activity. The last thing I wanted to do is show you part of an actual lesson so you could kind of get a feel for how the science program works and how this unit goes. So this is lesson 2 of the botany unit, and it tells you the objective, what you need to do to prepare, and then it tells you like the different experiments in detail so that you know exactly what you're doing. For history this year, we are not doing what we did last year. Last year, I thought I would be brave and create my own history curriculum, and whew, I really underestimated how hard that was gonna be. I spent so much time forming each unit on each country we were gonna study, and it was just way too much work, to be honest. So this year I'm going to simplify things for myself, and I found a program I think that we're going to really like. It's super hands-on, which fits my daughter to a T, and it is called Project Passport, and you can find it at homeschoolinthewoods.com, I believe. And so you can, they have Project Passport for various countries and various times. Not everything is on there, but we're gonna do Project Passport for Renaissance and Reformation, and Project Passport for the Middle Ages. The other countries that we're gonna study are Rome and Greece, but we're gonna do those through Khan Academy, and I might add a few little things into that on my own. So here's the Renaissance and Reformation Project Passport unit that I purchased, and you get a PDF and you open it up and this is what it looks like, and it sort of walks you through step by step exactly what you need to do. So the section here that says important, please read first, and it has all of those little sections there that you need to read. You really do need to read that, and once you do, you'll understand how everything goes together.
So what I like about this program is it's super creative the way they put it together. It's like you're taking a trip and each day is a different stop. And you can do more than one stop in a day if you have more time. But at each stop, you have a bunch of reading to do about that particular event or person. And you also have some various projects that you can work on, and it allows you to choose what you would like to do. You don't have to do all of them. You get a choice. In the travel tips section, they tell you all of the materials and supplies that you're going to need for the various projects and kind of how to go about it. So I thought this part was really handy also. The last thing I want to show you is the travel planner itinerary, and this breaks down each stop so that you know kind of like the different projects that you can do within each stop. So the little symbols at the top right that you'll see, like the SS and the camera and all of that, those mean different things. So like the LB is a lap book, the little headphones mean that there's an audio tour that you can listen to. So it's nice to know ahead of time the different things that you're going to have at each stop. Okay, so the rest of this, it goes into detail as to what you need to do at each stop and exactly how to do it and what everything is. So in case you're like, well, what's a lap book or whatever, you know, the quick stop itinerary is just to give you an overview, and this goes into great detail as to what everything is. One of the things I really liked about this, the Good and the Beautiful English curriculum, is it doesn't just cover reading and writing. It also covers punctuation, grammar, spelling, vocabulary, art, and geography, in addition to reading and writing, which I thought was huge. So I love that it covers so many different areas. It's sort of like a all-in-one, like, you know, shampoo and conditioner together. Not a good example, maybe. Anyways, so I really like that about it. And so this book kind of just goes through and tells you exactly how to do it. But one thing I like is they give you these little daily checklists. So each day you're gonna do a sentence dictation with them, and they're gonna practice writing it. So that'll work on their spelling, their punctuation, and their auditory learning and their writing. And then you're going to either work on learning states and capitals or poetry memorization. Then they're gonna do either geography or grammar cards. So let me show you what this looks like. So these are the grammar cards, and they have these little cards, they're perforated, you just break them apart. And so question number one is, what is a noun? And on the back is the answer. And so they can quiz themselves, or you can quiz them, or a sibling can quiz them. I put these in three different folders. The first one is not learned. These are ones that my child doesn't know yet. And then I have two other folders, and one is learning, so ones that they're working on. And then the last one says mastered, and this is for the ones that they already know. And then you can review them again later if you want to. But the instructions say that they should be working on 5 to 10 of their grammar cards or their geography cards, which look very similar. And then the last two things on their daily checkbook is working on things out of the course book, which is this blue book that I showed you already. So they have some things in there they have to work on each day. And then they're reading. And so for their reading, they have two different books. There's a shared reader, which I imagine means you read it together. And then there's a personal reader, so things that they can read on their own. And it goes towards some sort of reading challenge. So like I said, I don't have this completely figured out, but I like that there's all these different aspects and it works on so many different avenues of English as well as art and geography. For math this year, we are going to do Khan Academy. If you're not familiar with Khan Academy, it's just khanacademy.org, I believe. And it has all different subjects all for free. And it goes from, I'm pretty sure it goes from pre-K all the way up through some college classes, so check that out if you're looking for some free homeschool curriculum. We're gonna try that for math this year because last year we used a program called Teaching Textbooks, and I loved it. I thought it was fantastic. If you have a child who struggles in math, I highly, highly recommend it. That's Teaching Textbooks. I think it's also .org. Having said that, my daughter did not enjoy it because it was a little bit cartoonish and she just felt like it was kind of babyish, so we're doing Khan Academy this year instead, and we'll see how it goes. For art and music this year, we're going to do exactly what we did last year because it worked and we liked it. So we used Art Kids Hub on YouTube, which is awesome. It's a dad and his kids. You should go check it out. And basically he teaches you how to draw anything and everything. So if your child has a specific interest, I guarantee you're going to find something regarding it there. He draws, you know, Star Wars figures, cars, animals, food, all kinds of stuff. I think he also shows you how to make some things out of origami, if I remember correctly. Anyways, it's great. So we're gonna use that, and let me show you some of the drawings my daughter did last year.
just so you can get an idea. I actually only have one of them here to show you, but her little banana with a face, which I thought was so cute. But lots of drawings like this, and she just really, really enjoyed it. So in the way of music, she has an ukulele and she loves to play, and we also have a guitar and a piano. So there's a wide variety of things we can do with that, and that's something I usually just pick a song or tell her to pick a song and to practice it for the week and then play it for me at the end of the week. So this is what we're doing. I hope that this is helpful for you, and maybe that you've seen, now that you've seen some of these curriculums, you might be like, oh, this is something that I feel like would fit really well for my child. If you have any questions, I am not an expert and I will not pretend to be one. However, I feel like I learned a ton in my first year of homeschooling and from watching lots of videos similar to this. So please comment down below if you have any questions at all. I am more than happy to help. You can also find me on Instagram at onehavenmaven, and you're welcome to DM me there too if you have any questions at all. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. It really helps my channel to be shown to lots of other women, and that is my goal, to help as many women as I can. Also, I'm going to put some other videos up here that you can watch after this that might be helpful, and I will see you in my next video, which will be coming next week. Until then, bye guys.